The Russian military has successfully test-launched the new RS-28 Sarmat ICBM, which NATO has dubbed Satan II. Russian President Vladimir Putin said on Russian TV shortly after the test flight, according to The Guardian, "The Sarmat has the highest tactical and technical characteristics and is capable of overcoming all modern means of anti-missile defense. It has no analogues in the world and will not have for a long time to come." Putin stated, "This truly unique weapon will strengthen the combat potential of our armed forces, reliably ensure Russia's security in the face of external threats, and will provide food for thought to those who, in the heat of frenzied aggressive rhetoric, try to threaten our country." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia's latest missile, Sarmat, is the most powerful ICBM in the world. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by NordVPN. NordVPN is a premium VPN service available for macOS, iOS, Windows, and Android with more than 5,400 servers in 60 countries. But why use a VPN or virtual private network? VPN is an encrypted tunnel. A VPN can protect your privacy, which is threatened by many factors like data logging by internet service providers. It can also help you access contents which are blocked based on geolocation. Why NordVPN? Its servers are fast and has zero log policy. Not only this, NordVPN has taken one step further and recently introduced a new feature, threat protection. Threat protection prevents malware from getting on users' devices and blocks trackers, intrusive and malicious ads, and harmful websites. Use the link in the description to get up to 71% off the 2-year plan plus threat protection for no extra cost. At the checkout, use the code DEFENSE to get an extra month for free. Sarmat was introduced during a 2018 Russian State of the Nation address as the next generation of weaponry that could breach any missile defense system. According to the concept of MAD, mutually assured destruction, if the other side knew that initiating a nuclear strike would also inevitably lead to their own destruction, they will not initiate a nuclear attack. So basically, MAD prevents nuclear war. As the United States and NATO are improving their ballistic missile defense (BMD) systems, MAD is getting threatened, since USA or NATO may be able to intercept Russia's current nuclear missiles like R-36 Satan. Sarmat has been designed specifically to penetrate any current or future BMD system so that Russia can maintain nuclear deterrence vis-a-vis the United States and NATO. Sarmat is a 3-stage missile and uses liquid propellant, the exact nature of which is classified. The missile has a speed of over Mach 20.7. It weighs in at a massive 200 tons, making it the heaviest missile in the world. To give viewers a perspective, the U.S. land-based strategic missile, LGM-30 Minuteman III, has a weight of 35 tons, approximately. Speaking to Radio Sputnik, Alexei Leonov, a military expert and commercial director of Arsenal of the Fatherland magazine, provided insight about the missile some time back. The military expert emphasized that Sarmat will serve as a reliable deterrent. Leonov highlighted the particular interest of the US and European mainstream media towards the Russian missile, which was dubbed the Devil in Disguise, Satan, and weapons of nuclear hell. Leonov said, "Let them call it what they want. The Sarmat missile system, which is about to enter into service, is a 5th-generation system. Its characteristics are so impressive that our opponents have reason to be afraid of it." According to some estimates, the missile's striking range is up to 18,000 kilometers, or 11,184.6 miles. It also has a large number of divided parts, from 10 to 15 warheads, each with a capacity of up to 750 kilotons. They'll fly to their target at hypersonic speeds, performing maneuvers so that the existing American missile defense system would be incapable of intercepting them. Little Boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima had a yield of 15 kilotons of TNT. Sarmat's cumulative explosive power will be 15 warheads multiplied by 750 kilotons, which is around 11,000 kilotons of TNT. It will also be able to accommodate hypersonic boost glide vehicle as well as decoys. The Russian news outlet Sputnik reported that a single Sarmat is capable of wiping out parts of the Earth the size of France or Texas. At the end of June 2015, it was reported that the production schedule for the first prototype of the Sarmat was slipping. The RS-28 Sarmat was expected to become operational in 2016. On the 10th of August 2016, Russia successfully tested the RS-28's first stage engine, named PDU-99. The first image of this new missile was declassified and unveiled in October 2016. It was reported earlier that the production process had been accelerated and that the missiles would make up almost 100% of Russia's fixed, land-based nuclear arsenal by the end of the year. Land-based missiles are vulnerable to preemptive strikes, and hence Russian experts are going to great lengths to shield Sarmat. The Sarmat silos will be protected by active protection measures, including 100 guns capable of firing a metallic cloud of 40,000 30mm bullets to an altitude of up to 6 kilometers or 3.7 miles. The Russians are also planning to protect the Sarmat with their new S-500 air defense systems. With a planned range of 600 kilometers or 370 miles for anti-ballistic missiles (ABM) and 500 kilometers (310 miles) for air defense, the S-500 would be able to detect and simultaneously engage up to 10 ballistic hypersonic targets flying at a speed of 5 kilometers per second (that's 3.1 miles per second) to a limit of 7 kilometers per second or 4.3 miles per second. Finally, the missile's preparation to launch is under 60 seconds, utilizing a highly automated launch system. It's clear that the Super Heavy Sarmat is probably the most destructive individual platform ever built. The timing of the test is significant here. The Kremlin strategy of escalate to de-escalate has included threats to use nuclear weapons since the early 2000s, according to Matthew Kronick, deputy director of Atlantic Council's Scowcroft Center for Strategy and Security and the director of its Scowcroft Strategy Initiative. Putin has made nuclear threats in his 2014 invasion of Ukraine, warning other nations about the consequences of interfering, said Kronick, who is also a Georgetown University professor. It's clear that the latest test of Sarmat has been done as a warning to the West.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.